Howdy. Thanks for learning about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this YouTube channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between visits. And it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. This video, I'm going to try out something I haven't done on YouTube yet, and that's discuss a research article. I'll throw up an abstract from a recently published article I found on PubMed, entitled Residual Disability After Severe Relapse in People with Multiple Sclerosis Treated with Disease-Modifying Therapies. Now, this is an article that was published by a group of authors, first author, Asheron, and it is a really worthwhile thing to look at. And so what happened here is they took a group of people with multiple sclerosis, in fact, 1,672 people with MS, that are currently taking disease-modifying therapies. And so you're dealing with a group of modern treated MS patients. And they looked at their charts for attacks they had suffered. And they defined a severe attack as someone who has an attack and suffered 2 points of disability on the EDSS scale. So their exam got significantly worse by 2 points. And they defined that as severe. Now, when they looked at these 1,600 plus patients, 17% of the attacks were considered severe. And the questions asked, how well did those people with MS recover from their severe attacks? And the short answer is not very well. And what we see from this paper, when you look at a patient who suffered a severe attack, and you ask what percentage still had a 1 point residual deficit, meaning they recovered, but they didn't fully recover. So they lost 2 points on the disability scale, they only got 1 point back. They still have a full point of accrued disability 1 year later. And the answer is an unpleasant one. 48% of those patients who suffered a severe attack still had a 1 point residual deficit in the EDSS a year later. Now, if you look at the ones that didn't recover at all, they had at least a 2 point disability from their severe attack. And a year later, they still had 2 points of disability. That was 20% of the patients, or a fifth of the patients, a year later had accrued 2 points of disability. Sometimes patients ask me, why should I bother taking a medicine? Why do I need to bother doing this? And this is the answer. You may not have attacks very frequently. In fact, we hope that you don't have attacks very frequently. But if you do, as explained in this cohort, a percentage of those patients, almost 20%, are going to have a severe attack. And amongst those with a severe attack, about 50% will have a significant disability without meaningful recovery, and about one-fifth, 20%, may not recover at all. This is the reason that we want you to take something prophylactically. The disease-modifying therapies are really birth control pills against future attacks. And I think this paper does a great job of reminding us why we don't want to risk incomplete recovery from a severe attack. Once again, my name is Aaron Boster, and thanks for learning about MS with me. Today, I've taken a few moments to review a research article entitled Residual Disability After Severe Relapse in People with MS Treated with Disease-Modifying Therapy. If you found this review helpful, please leave a comment down in the section below. Feel free to give it a like. And if you'd like to see more content from me, picking apart multiple sclerosis and upping your MS game, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. Until my next video, take care.